Hello and welcome to Math Level I. I'm Bea and I'm so excited to learn with you in this course. Before we dive into the math together, let's talk about what you can expect from this course so you can make the most out of all of the resources we have for you. Let's start with how your lessons will look in this course. Each lesson comes with an activity checklist that will usually divide tasks over 1 to 3 days. That way, you're not trying to do everything in a lesson all at once. The best place to see the activity checklist is at the top of the printable PDF or in the workbook. To access the individual lesson PDF, click on the lesson tile from your learning path and locate PDF on the list of lesson contents on the left. From there, you can download and print it, load it into a digital editor, or use it in any other way that works best for you. If you haven't done so already, pause the video to locate and download the PDF for this lesson. It looks like this. Ask your trusted adult for help if you need it. You can see the activity checklist at the top of this cover sheet. This is your home base for what's ahead. Let's break down the activities in this sample lesson. The cover sheet will include the learning objectives for each lesson and a list of necessary skills that will help you master the new material. There will also be a warm-up exercise to get your brain in the math zone. Now, back to this activity checklist. This tells you what tasks are suggested for each day. Notice these small icons. They indicate the type of tasks that are in the lesson. In this example, we start with a video and guided notes, kind of like this introductory lesson. The video will be linked on the left in the list of lesson contents. But where can you find the guided notes? Yep, the next page after the cover sheet. You can tell you're in the right spot because the icons in the gray banner at the top will match the icons from the cover sheet. If you haven't already found the guided notes for this lesson, pause here while you find them and start following along. At the end of the guided notes, you'll have a chance to check in with yourself and reflect on your understanding of the objectives. This reflection can help you decide whether you're ready to move on to the lesson activities or whether it would be helpful to go back to your notes or re-watch parts of the video. After you've completed the guided notes and watched the lesson video, you will move on to the online practice. Notice, this sample lesson has practice levels split up across both days. Where can you find the online practice? Right, online practice is online. More specifically, the practice levels are linked directly in the list of lesson contents. To stay on track with the recommended schedule, make sure you stop for the day after completing the assigned levels and earning a medal. Speaking of the online practice, if you ever want a printed version of the online practice questions, ask your trusted adult to print them for you from their parent portal. Let's see what's next in our lesson. Up next, we have an Algonautin simulation, notated by this rocket ship icon. These simulations, which are linked directly in the list of lesson contents, will allow you to dive deeper in the math and engage with exercises beyond simple paper and pencil work or multiple choice online practice. Well, we've wrapped up day one of our example lesson. What activity should we do to start day two? Well, according to our activity checklist, we need to start with an activity called Practice Makes Progress. This icon indicates it's a PDF activity, which can be found on the pages of the lesson PDF following the guided notes. The first page of each activity will have a banner with this icon and the activity's name at the top. Activities should be treated like practice. This is where you'll have an opportunity to strengthen the new skills you learned in the video. Now, let's talk about bonus gold. How do you get it? Throughout our lessons, you'll see some questions or activities labeled as bonus. These are opportunities for you to go beyond the content from that lesson. While bonuses are optional, I highly encourage you to try them so you can push yourself and strengthen your understanding of these concepts. Each activity has a suggested amount of bonus gold that your trusted adult can choose to give you as a reward for trying it. Last up in our sample lesson, there is an assessment. These are official opportunities for you to see how you're doing with the material in each unit. You'll take the assessment on the Mia platform, but you can also ask your trusted adult for a printed version if you'd like one. For most units in Math Level I, you'll have a mid-unit assessment, usually around 10 questions long. At the end of each unit, there will be an assessment, usually around 15 questions long, which will measure your mastery of each lesson in that unit. Your trusted adult can see your assessment scores. They can also help you figure out what to review if you didn't quite nail it the first time, which is part of learning. Now that we've looked at the breakdown of our lessons, let's discuss some habits you should start or continue that will help you succeed in this course. Before I share my thoughts, pause and write some of your ideas in the space provided in your guided notes. Well, for starters, it's a great idea to pause the video as needed to record important concepts, complete examples, or rewind to hear an explanation again. In many lesson videos, I'll ask you to pause and complete example problems independently. But of course, you can also pause the video anytime you feel you need a minute to catch up or hear something again. Since you'll be taking your time pausing the video and creating thorough guided notes, you'll want to make sure to keep those notes organized in a folder or binder. Even after the unit is over, consider storing those notes in a safe place in case you need to come back to them later. As you know, math concepts often build upon previous skills, so you never know when your notes will come in handy. Speaking of previous skills, you may wish from time to time to revisit previous lesson videos or online practices if you find yourself struggling. Ask your trusted adult to reassign relevant lessons or use the All Lessons tab to search for specific concepts. You may have even more great ideas for how to set yourself up for success. I encourage you to practice them all as you work through Math Level I. I know you are going to do great. Thanks for exploring this course with me. You're all set to get started. Finish up these guided notes and complete your first practice level to check your understanding. Until next time, remember, math is everywhere. Keep exploring. Hey, hey.